Here, two dreams are joined together. Dreams that bespeak both the repose and flight of being, evening's crystallization and wings that open to the light. In the body of the winged manor, which dominates both town and sea, man and you and the universe, he retained a cottage chrysalis in order to be able to hide alone in complete repose. I once said that by examining the rhythms of life in detail, by descending from the great rhythms forced upon us by the universe, to the finer rhythms that play upon man's most exquisite sensibilities, it would be possible to work out a rhythm analysis that would tend to reconcile and lighten the ambivalences that psychoanalysts find in the disturbed psyche. But if what poets say is true, alternating daydreams cease to be rivals. Take into account our need for retreat and expansion, for simplicity and magnificence, for here we experience a rhythm analysis of the function of inhabiting. To sleep well, we do not need to sleep in a large room, and to work well, we do not have to work in a den. But to dream of a poem, then write it, we need both. And how many dreamers look everywhere in their house or in their room for the garment that suits them?